And welcome to the Knitting Samurai Plus One video podcast, episode 48. I am your host, Steph, also known as the Knitting Samurai. And let's see, this episode I think is going to be called Two FOs. If you're new to the podcast, thanks for checking me out. I hope you enjoy what you see. And if you're a returning viewer, thanks so much for joining me. I really appreciate it. I know you have lots of podcast viewing options out there, and I love it that you come back and see me. So there's a discussion group over on the RAV boards, so under Knitting Samurai Plus One. If you'd like to go over there and chat it up or join the group, love to see you, love to talk to you. Right now there is a forum open about doing a swap, and I gave everybody some choices, and I think the majority of people went with the doing a swap for yarn plus some goodies. So, haven't really worked out details, but I'm thinking if we do yarn in the $20 to $25 range and then $5 for goodies inside the package, let's set a date of Don't you love making decisions on air? It's very fun. And you know what? This is a long episode. I have a lot to show you. So let's just say I'm going to open signups. I'll post a questionnaire of things to fill out. And then the magical elves will come along and assign people their swap partner. And we can all just look back in the thread, and you'll find your person and what they like and what you need to do for them. So I think it'll be fun. So we're going to do a yarn swap. That's a very tangential way around to get to. We're going to do a yarn swap. So yeah, over on the board. And this is Senor Linus. Oh, and you may have noticed different couch, different situation. We actually were a little crazy and sold our light tan couches that little one, every time he wiped his nose, or I know that's disgusting to say, but they slobber and they don't think about it and they smear it everywhere. So every time he got near the couch, it was pretty much a wet spot, and there were just stains that's 6-7 years old. And so we sold them. We sold the couch and the love seat for $200. I'm sorry. I know it's rude to talk money, but I'm so excited. $200 to this really nice young couple. Steve vacuumed them and wiped them down a bit so they looked a lot better. but yeah, they just graduated college. They were so excited to have him. It kind of reminded of me of us. Actually, we bought the condo in 06? Car, condo, 05, married. That's the way I remember it. 03, I graduated college. 04, I bought my first car, like straight from a dealer. 05, we bought our condo. In 06, we got married. I know, we did them in a funny order there. But yeah, so we had them like a 6 years, 6.5 years at that point. So they took those, and we went out and bought a sectional. So this is our second day with it. It's brand spanking new, and it's dark brown, which I've only ever had tan and green couches. Okay, I'm so telling you way more than you ever wanted to know. So usually when you get me at the end of the day, it is, what is today? March 20th, 21st? Whatever Wednesday is this week. 20th, I think. It's the 20th. Yesterday was a snow day. I didn't get a chance to record yesterday, so I'm recording tonight. And usually when you get me after work, I'm scatterbrained and my words don't come out right. So instead of that, tonight you're getting verbal, just lots of it coming at you. And really, I should be saving all of this chatter for telling you about my knitting and my two FOs. So let's start. Last week these were almost done, so I'm not going to put a lot of energy into talking about them, but these are socks from one of our friends. They are just a plain 2x2 toe-up sock construction with a gusseted heel flap on there. I used Patton's Croy Rag, I think it's just cotton Croy Rag shades, and this is the gray brown marl, which is funny to me because the color that catches your eye or my eye the most is the red, but that's not in the color name. And yeah, that's about all I have to say about these. So they're done. I even wove in my ends because I was like, if you at least have to finish them. So that's done. The other FO this week that I have to show you. So last time we talked, I showed you my Arbutus by Jean Richmond. And that was knit with worsted weight yarn, Cricut, I believe. And that nice slate blue color. So this is my Knitty and Color. I have such a hard time with that. Knitty and Color yarn. And it is her Not Drinking Merlot colorway, which is a fingering weight yarn. You did not see this before. I knit it in 3 days, really fast. I could have knit it in one if I had been focused. Not Drinking Merlot, that's a fingering weight yarn, so I held it double. Used US size 9, so, you know, tweaked the pattern just slight little tiny bit. And I have to say that the second time through on the Arbutus was much easier than the first time. I knew what was going on. I knew what to expect. It's almost like you need a roadmap, maybe a schematic to help you figure out where you're going. I don't know. But anyway, so this one came out a lot nicer. What I noticed about it is that fuzz. The first one I knit is very drapey and just sort of loose, and I wore it to work one day last week, and by the end of the day, it felt like it had grown 3 inches, I swear. And that is a wool bamboo mix, I'm gonna say, or wool rayon mix, 50-50. So this, I can feel how dense it is and how structured, and I feel like it's not gonna move, like it's gonna stay there. It's ultimately going to be warmer than the real drapey loose one. So here's my second FO of this week. I know. My notes are on my iPad. Happy face. My notes are on my iPad and it keeps shutting off on me. So sorry for having to pay attention to this. I don't like to do that normally. My Pebble Beanie, that's by Elizabeth Parker. As you'll remember, this came out of the Weekend Knits book. I have the dryers done, beep. I was trying to get myself to do 2 rows a day on this. So it's coming along again, slow progress. This is Shaper Nicole in the Empress Zhao colorway. So I'm sure from that far away and with the camera's focus. Oh, I hope the lighting's good enough. Let me know if it's not, if it's too dark, and then I won't try and record at night with this new light setting. We have a different situation up in there. Anyways, yeah, and this is my spotlight that I knit by, and usually I turn it on and point it at the opposite couch that I record on, so it's shining at me, and we have not, it's just different lighting. You don't care what my lighting is, but my knitting light's not gonna help for podcasting unless I show. Maybe I'll change directions. We'll see. We'll see. It's a developing thing. But I think in person, the colors blend a little more, although that yellow does pop quite a bit. But I love the woven texture of this fabric. Absolutely love it. Love it. So it kills my hands to knit it. And 2 rows takes a good bit of time, 45 minutes to an hour. No, that's 4 rows. So there's a pattern row and then there's an easy row. So if I do 2 pattern rows, then yeah, that's 45 minutes to an hour. It's a commitment, but it's coming. It's coming along. So, and I love working with that yarn. It's 100% merino yarn, and I've been saving it. It's for special yarn, and so it's nice to finally use it and do something. So, lean way over, and show you that inside my Erin Lane bag is my Peasy. What's up, Melissa? You abandoned me. I totally agree. This pattern has so many things going on at the same time, and I may very well have screwed it up, and I now haven't touched it in 2 weeks. So this is the Peasy by Heidi Karamere. It's a cardigan sweater that you can convert to a Henley, which I'm planning on doing. Haven't touched it in a very long time. Screwed up with the needle gauge. Tried to adapt as I'm going. Not sure it's gonna work out. There's what the pattern looks like. We'll see. For now, I'm just going to say, know that the PZ is lingering out there, and until I deal with Grace, the other sweater I'm knitting right now, the PZ's in timeout. Just, it's more than my brain can handle. And you know what? Once I'm through the raglan increases, it's just a straight stockinette body and simple sleeve shaping. Like, it's going to be a piece of cake. I've done this before. Cat just ran down the stairs and jumped on the hardwood floor. Here he comes. He's running like a tear. Oh, and the other one jumped out. Play-by-play action. Here he comes. He's stopping on the table. Okay, anyways. I'm sorry. Right now, Mac is standing on the coffee table and laying on my glasses. Do you think a 13-pound cat will hurt my glasses? I know. Most people tell me my cats are small for cats, but he weighs 13 pounds. I should be watching the time because the camera is going to shut off on me. I know it is. There was no cat, and now there is a cat. Okay. Grace. Grace. That was a really bad... There's a YouTube song called Grace. It's a beautiful song. I am not Bono, so I will not sing it to you. Anyway. Have fun with it. You know, I hope you were sitting there laughing and going, this girl, what are we going to do with her? Either she's over-caffeinated or she's overtired. And either way, she's just silly. She's just silly. She's a mommy and she's silly. Oh, boy. Okay, here comes the story. So this week, he was running around with one of those big board puzzles that has, I think they're called pegs, has knobs that you pull out and they look like, oh, I forgot my book I was going to show you. I have to go get it. The book I was going to show you is Dinosaurs Think It by Sandra Boynton. This is currently Roland's favorite book. It's interactive. There are flips, pages, there's blankets that move. It's a great book. We read it every night at least once before bed. Linus would like to go in the garage. And I just think it's the cutest thing ever. Dinosaur, oh dinosaur, dreaming dreams unknown. Your smile makes me wish I had a binket of my own. So the dinosaur can't say blanket, he says binket. So this is him. He's super cute. Roland needs a knit dinosaur. Oh my god. And the binket feels like a ShamWow towel. Remember from the infomercial, ShamWow? Just so happens we had some of those. I did not buy them. He, Steve, husband, totally did. I don't know what came over him, late night infomercial thing, but... So we have ShamWows. I could cut him one. And I could knit him a green dinosaur with dark green scales based on the Rebecca Danger T-Rex pattern. And then make him run PJs. It's gonna be so cute. So... This is what I'm spending my time while I'm knitting on Grace and swearing in my head I'm envisioning my dinosaur. And my dinosaur blanket. So, anyways, shall we talk about knitting? Maybe? Knitting-based knitting, not children book-based knitting. I cast on the... What did I cast on? Grace. The Grace pattern. And I'm knit row. That just... Don't you hate it when podcasters do that? So I'll show you the back. The Grace pattern by Jane Richmond. So this is a top-down cardigan because that's what I'm in favor of knitting right now. I'm holding it upside down. Do you want me to hold it right side up? It has this great lace detail. I screwed it up. On the top, I screwed up the increases. I've talked about this before. There are so many errors in this pattern. By user error, not designer error. The pattern is very well written. It's insane. And I'm working through it. So you may notice, I don't know if I had a sleeve last time I showed you, but I have a sleeve. Well, that far. And then I went back to knitting on the body. Now, I knit about 6 inches on the body, below the lace, and tied it on. I could cross them, and the two ends were like out here. Clearly there was a problem with my gauge calculation. I swatched on the sleeves, so yeah, I know. I swatched while I knit. I swatched with 7s, and came up with a gauge of 4.5 stitches to inch. I somehow, in all of my tricksiness and stitch holes, putting, changing needles, ended up knitting the body of it, after the lace portion, on size 8. Which, okay, it's one needle size difference, but when they're that large a needle, one needle size difference means that 8 got me 4 stitches to the inch and took my 47-inch bust up to a 55-inch bust. So I was burning through my yarn, which is, did he steal my label? It is new tweed. This is a discontinued. It's actually not new. It's vintage.
It's old.
It's some of the oldest yarn in my stash. It's a 70 wool, 15 silk, 10 cashmere, 4 viscose, 100 yards. First skein, and I have 10 of them. So I was burning through my skeins way too fast, and I realized that I had knit 5 skeins, and if I was going to use one of the other 5 for the arm, the opposite arm, the second arm, if you will, which left me 4, and I was going to get like a 10-inch sweater at that rate of giving up an extra 7, 8 inches. So I had to go, because there needs to be a button band too, like, ugh! So I frogged, and I used the ball winder to frog and roll and stood on the sweater while I frogged, you know, just twirled and he yelled and pointed, and he's very funny. He loves the ball winder. And it's funny, if you talk to Steve about ball winders, he has very fond memories of his mother using a ball winder when he was a kid, because she's knit his whole life on and off and machine knit and for professionally. Anyways, so he remembers that cranking sound and the motion, and he was so funny the first day I brought it home. It was like, oh wow, you do that. You really are doing that. So I frogged it, and I forced myself to sit down, and even still, I knit like 2-3 rows, I think, and then I checked my gauge again on the 7s, and it was still more stitches than I needed, and so I started just decreasing real fast. So, moral of the story is, at the chest about here where they meet, it might overlap a little bit. Fine. Or it might have some extra fabric. Fine. I don't care. I don't care. Or the lace on the front panel might not block out as much. That's probably what will happen when I block it and then pin it to the right dimensions. But it's fine. It's fine. I'm rolling with it. So this will be my sweater of, that's fine. Just let it go. Let it go. Letting it go. That's what this knitting is. Do you ever knit like that? It's really freeing. Like, do you remember back when the Stockknit Zombies did their crazy cow? Cow. Crazy cow. I wanted to join in, but I didn't because I couldn't think of anything. Well, if I were to have a crazy cow right now, this sweater would totally be in it. Because just letting mistakes go and not going back and saying, yeah, the lace is completely off on this. I'm knitting some sort of other sweater than the one that Jane Richmond designed. I probably shouldn't even attribute it to that, but it's fine, you know? My increases are, you know, the raglan increases are 2 wide on one side and 1 wide on the other side. Eh. Oh, there's extra fabric. So, that is the grace. That is grace. What is the meaning of grace? I should look that up. Maybe I'm getting grace from knitting the grace. Maybe it's graceful to, I'm gonna stop. I'm gonna stop and talk about my purse knitting. I put my PZ away. No, this is not PZ, but Grace away. My purse knitting, I already talked about that, is, of course, a pair of socks. So these, because I like knitting stripy yarn, and because I'm a good granddaughter, are for my grandmother, finally. I know. I said I was going to knit her socks and slippers. It's March. I haven't done either. So these are socks for her in this great Pattens Croix. They should really be sponsoring me, or at least this episode. This Pattens Croix yarn. I believe this is also the rag shades, but this one is blue rag. Blue something. And Linus finds the nails very interesting, but not as interesting as his grooming. So you can see where I'm at. This one is about 6 inches long, and I need to start gusset increases at 7.5. And this one's just a little less. So just 2x2 toe up my regular generic sock pattern. Here's the yarn in the skein. If you're curious, I'm knitting on US 1.5, 2.75 millimeter needles, or 2.5 millimeter needles. I don't know. I'm sure the Canadians out there know. So those are going along everywhere, all the time. I had a very long, boring meeting this week, and I was like, last week, can I bring them? Would anyone notice if I sat in the back? But I'm a chicken. And plus, only my immediate coworkers know my deep, dark secret. And lastly, I'll show you a picture. It's not a picture of me. So something came over me, and I decided I told you there are three coworkers who are pregnant, right? And I love them. And so they're getting lots of knitted goodness for their babies. And maybe one, if not all, are going to get this Chadwick, the Shakespearean caterpillar by Rebecca Danger. I bought the pattern yesterday. Again, it was a snow day. A work from home snow day, but snow day nonetheless. And cast on. And I really hope no one at work is watching this because I don't want everyone to know. But she's so smart. So this is a caterpillar, right? Obviously. She suggests putting all kinds of fun things in the different sections of the body. So we went to Target tonight and I got some cat toys, which make all kinds of noise, right? And it won't matter because it's inside of the caterpillar. And I also got pipe cleaner so that I can pose him. I don't think she says that, but I thought it would be really cool to put pipe cleaner in his arms and stuff. So here's my first section. I am using Knit Picks Felicie Sport in the Dockside colorway, which is this color right here. It's a blue, gray, light blue, light red. So there's rubber pulling in it. Like, that's what the light colors are. It's the gray and the red and the gray and the blue. Really cool. I like it so much. So looking at this, I have to knit six and seven for the head of the caterpillar, because centipedes aren't cute. Caterpillars, very cute. So I have to do that. I'm using two skeins because one stripe sequence of the Felicie isn't enough to do a section of the body, so I'm just using two of them. And the colors, I know, I could be piecing together odds and ends, and maybe I will for one of the other ones. And I'm not saying I'll knit all three of them, but I'm definitely knitting one of them this. So I could piece together my own colors, but someone else figured this out and decided they look good. I have a really hard time with color. Just like one of the pictures that I constantly have on here, I'll show it to you, is, not that it will matter to you, but it could help you, it could be a good idea, is I keep a color wheel on here telling me primary, tertiary, so like this blue, red, and, or orange, blue, yellow, red go well together, but then the like lighter lines go well together. Just helping me get a sense of what's a good color mixture, because I'm really bad at that. I'm also bad at putting outfits together. Unless they're for an 18-month-old, and then I can make him look pretty snazzy, I have to say. Now, you've got proud mommy, I'm just going to show you. Almost it. Oh my god, it's taking forever. Fuck! Okay, I'm done. He's a badass. Anyways. Okay.
What's up?
So that is Chadwick, the Shakespearean caterpillar, so far. And you stuff him as you go, and then he's done. And because I'm using sport weight yarn and US 1's 2.25, I do know these are 2.25 millimeter needles, She's saying that it should come out about 16 inches tall. So, oh, but I'm altering the pattern a little bit. I'm making the sections a little smaller. Just otherwise, I would have to use 3 skeins of yarn to get the right length of yarn. Do you know what I'm saying? Anyways, yes, here comes articulate Stephanie. So, oh my God, I was about ready to end the show and I was totally forgetting that it is the middle of March and it is time for a 2013 goals update. Here's my update for you, helping me stay honest and on track with what I want to knit this year. So, 13 self-striping socks. So first pair I knit was the Schools in Session. Second pair was the 716 Prayer socks for my cousin. Third pair, the pair of socks I just finished over here. So 3 out of 13 done, and it's March. Check. Next was 13 patterns from books. So I have knit the Welted Toque. I have knit, which was from, well, it took was from Weekend Hat, and I have now knit 2 Arbutus, which is from Jane Richmond's Island book. 3 out of 13 done. Check! One of the other goals was one vest for Dad, 2 baby blankets, and 3 Christmas stockings. Unfortunately, I've only knit 1 baby blanket, which was the pie shawl / baby blanket. I finished a couple weeks ago, so 1 out of 6 done there. 13 sweaters. So far this year, I'm so proud of this. And even if I only get halfway through, that's fine. Or even if I only knit 6 for me and 6 for Roland / other babies, fine. So 13 sweaters. I have knit the Harvest Moon and the Dark and Stormy. Did I tell you I wore it to work? It looked awesome. I spent the whole day jumping around and telling everyone to look at my back because I was so proud of my work. And they were so sweet to me about it. So 2 out of 13 done there. And the Grace and the Peasy on the Needles to finish it up. And then 13 oldest yarns. Knit them up, get them out. So the Pie Shawl blanket was one of the oldest yarns. And the Grace is with one of the oldest yarns. So I'm calling that 1 out of 13 done there. So not so great, but I'm still going on it. So thank you for checking in with me. I hope you have a great 10 days or so until I see you again. Enjoy what's going on in your knitting world. Take care. I love you. Mwah! Good night.